And now it's my great honor and privilege to be sitting here with one of the legendary figures of American cinema. It's Sidney Lumet. Hey, well, Sidney.
Hey.
It's midnight on Channel 56 and we're still doing this, which I think is wonderful. I loved your movie.
Thank you.
It's one of the best films of the year. And young man, I think you are headed to the Oscar podium again this year.
Well, what shall I wear?
Don't wear this. I look like hell. If the devil knows you're dead, I wore every hellish color I could think of.
You got
and
him
now
on
there's
today.
No camera. You but anyway.
You got him on today.
Yeah, well, I Best Director, I think you're going to get nominated. Best Picture, Best Actor, Philip Seymour Hoffman, Best Ethan Hoffman. I know. I'm a supporting actor. I predict these things.
Okay.
I'm like the Oracle of Delphi.
Okay.
New Jersey. You know? So I can, people tune into, like, I'm the man who knows Oscar, that's what I'm known as. So, this script, now, was this an original script or a book, or what was it first?
It was an original script by Kelly Masterson, and a marvelous, marvelous story, which is the reason I did it. I love good stories. That's enough for me, very often.
Yes, and it's a very strong family drama, which starts off with these two brothers, and then they decide to rob a mom and pop store, and I don't want to reveal anything else. This is sort of a mystery.
Now,
it's a crime drama.
Yeah, and it's a strange piece, the fractured time thing, which was also an invention of the writer, is another interesting element about it, where you suddenly flash back to an earlier point, continue up to the point at which you did flashback, and then pass that to continue telling the story. And a very imaginative script, I thought.
Sidney, I want to ask you this question. I've been thinking about it for years. Every time I see your movies, how do you get such great performances out of all of your actors?
Let's start with one simple premise, one simple truth, really, which is you don't get anything out of anybody that isn't there. I'm no miracle person.
Interesting.
It's only a question of will you prepare the groundwork well enough? Will they develop the confidence to let those things come out? And there I can be of some help because the rehearsal process is a help.
You rehearse?
Very heavily.
I didn't know that. Wonderful. Very few directors do that. That's mm-hmm. very interesting. Mm-hmm. Because you do these gritty New York films, and I'm not being a gritty New York talk show host. I love this. You know, mm-hmm. I grew up mm-hmm. on your films, and I mm-hmm. crave them. And now we've got another one, a great one, with the Before the Devil Knows You're Dead. So you rehearse. How long did you rehearse?
2 weeks.
Okay.
And it's a complete rehearsal. I mean, we get up on our feet. By the end of the second week, we're doing a run-through of the whole movie.
So everybody who works with you has to have a stage training, is what you're
not implying. Necessarily. Not necessarily.
In this film, they happen. They all
yeah,
do actually.
Yeah. Well, actually, if you work here, if you work in New York, you're going to get actors who are heavily committed and bound to the theater because that's the main reason for being here.
Isn't their dedication wonderful? To be in New York and to be an actor is more difficult, I'm sorry, than being in Hollywood and being an actor.
I don't know. I don't know because one thing, it's more difficult because there's less work, but there is also more satisfaction here than there is there. I don't think...
That's why we stay.
I don't think that you can get... can work 14 hours a day, 12 days in a row, and come out with much satisfaction. Which is what a lot of them have to do on their series.
Right. Well, I mean, there is that thing, there is that feeling in New York that you're working with your brain. I go to L.A., I feel like parts of the brain cells are disappearing the longer I stay there. But Before the Devil Knows You're Dead is a very powerful film. It's very disturbing. And it's also very sexy. That first scene, was that in the script as written?
Where no, I did that. I did that on my own.
Oh, God. Well, you know the Academy will continue watching all the way through this. Marissa keeps taking her top off. Philip and Marissa have a very heavy nude sex scene at the beginning of the film.
Mm-hmm.
Did Philip?
Why? Because it really is that kind of life away from everything in Rio. Not bothered by the reality
right.
of where he normally lives, that's the way he wants to live.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
And because I don't like sexual scenes for the sake of themselves. There's a real purpose to that. scene.
Yes, they were so happy. Mm. That's what happens in that scene. You see a husband and wife, I think,
right.
having a wonderful sex life.
Right.
And they're in Rio. And
yeah.
I mean, I wanted to go to Rio after I saw that film.
You can go anytime.
But I can go to the Bronx, basically, these days.
And before the devil knows you're dead, the interview's over, Sydney. Okay. Thank you so much for being here today on the Stephen Holt Show.